If there is one thing that fascinates me about our time, it is that the eventual discovery of the theory of everything might coincide with what I call a practice of nothing. Exactly at the moment that we would understand the cosmos and ourselves, we would also understand that we had gone too far. Thousands of years of philosophy and science have been preparing us for this magical moment. But then, when we would see the truest light for the first time, it would coincide with the beginning of eternal darkness, something you can see behind me. Would this really be a coincidence? How would this relate to our current crisis in economy, in ecology, and to the possibility of a just world? For a philosopher, the times could not be more exciting. It is a privilege to live in the era in which mankind, for the first time, will be able to see who and where we are. In a new book, I try to understand why this revelation could come exactly at a time when a growing number of people do not believe anymore that we can find a way out of the multi-crisis in economy, in ecology, and human motivation simply because a solution is too complex, simply too complex. To get it right, I do not think that this theory of everything will simply be a synthesis of the theory of relativity and quantum mechanics. The final understanding of ourselves will be much deeper. Something beyond body and soul, matter and spirit, something beyond causality and coincidence. It will be a mirror in which we will recognize ourselves in a way never seen before. It was at this point that I began to see him. At first, I tried to neglect his voice. Maybe I was afraid of the consequences. But when I heard his name, the encounter was inevitable. Holo Faust. Some say he came by boat or train. Others saw him coming out of the Greenwich Underground station near London. Through the streets he walked, through the park, up to its highest point, the Royal Observatory. It was probably as a tourist that he found his way into the so-called Octagon Room. The Octagon Room. This unique place with its astronomical instruments had in the 17th century played a crucial role in the understanding of the cosmos. It was there, in that historic room, that Holo Faust stood. People stopped, looked at him, the man who out of nothing began to talk about something that mattered everything. The essence of Greenwich, he spoke, was that mankind once decided that this was the place of the so-called zero or prime meridian. For centuries, ships on the seven seas had only limited means of measuring their position. It was only after the invention of marine clocks and the installation of this prime meridian that there came an end to the avalanche of shipwrecks. From that moment on, ships could navigate, knowing the time at every particular place. The Greenwich Mean Time was born. Greenwich Mean Time. At first, Holo Faust sounded like a speaker at Hyde Park Corner. But then they began to feel it. It was something subtle, something huge and awesome. Nobody could reproduce how it happened, but everyone felt that they began to see and to believe. Some said that it was the inauguration of the zero meridian of good. Some called it the rebirth of trust in unconditioned love and altruism. Others knew for the rest of their lives that on this shiny day, Greenwich Mean Time had been complemented by the so-called Greenwich Good Time. Goodness became a place, a thing, something you could turn to in times of doubt or desperation when mankind lost track of its sense of morality on the oceans of time. As the saving of ships had begun with the definition of the zero meridian, so the rescue of ethics depended on this simple decision, that good is real and from now on has got a foundation in the material world. Goodness was there. And because of that, it gained strength inside him and her, me and you. People sensed that it was a line connecting everyone, a river of hope and remorse, the unique chance of making this world the most of all possible, the most human of all possible worlds. But when people started to realize this, he had already gone. Had he really been there? Did the Greenwich event really take place? Was his appearance a final call to mankind to save our souls? Probably there will be many last calls. And if you listen clearly, you can hear them right now. In the silence underneath our crisis, a silence which this man called Holofaust transformed into his particular universal voice. Thank you.